While COVID cases here in San Diego County are at their lowest totals in months, there's still some fears, concerns another surge could slow down progress. Of major concern is the UK variant, also known as the B117 strain. Here to join us again to talk more about it is UC San Diego researcher and associate professor, Dr. Natasha Martin. Dr. Martin, thank you for making time for us again here on The Four.
Thanks for having me.
Back in February, we talked about that B117. We talked about the different scenarios that had that strain having a big surge in March. Now, how has that played out? Has it played out how we expected, a little bit differently? What's going on with it right now?
So the B117 strain has increased in terms of its fraction of circulating strains. So of the COVID cases that we see, it's become an increasing percentage of those cases since the last time we talked, consistent with what the models were forecasting. So for example, you know, our more recent estimates is that just under half of cases in San Diego County are attributable to the B117 strain. What we haven't seen yet is a surge associated with the increased fraction of cases associated with that strain. One of the reasons why we haven't seen that so far is that we have had an unprecedentedly low level of transmission, and that we really haven't seen over the course of this pandemic. So transmission rates in the last month and a half have been the lowest that they have ever been. Really, I think attesting to the fantastic job that people have done in terms of increasing and maintaining their adherence to masking and social distancing. What that means is that, as everybody has seen, cases have continued to decline and put us in a position where, as this variant continues to expand and become an increasing fraction of cases, we are much better able to manage any potential surge that might happen or reversal of that declining trend because of the increased transmissibility. I think we still have yet to see whether B117 does result in a sort of reversal in the declines in cases that we've seen. A lot of that depends on behavior. But the bottom line is that people have done a fantastic job in San Diego of reducing transmission, maintaining high adherence to masking, and ensuring that we didn't get in a position where we saw a severely escalating case counts so far.
Dr. Martin, with that good news, is there a danger of people becoming a little too relaxed? Could we get into some kind of trouble, even with the number of vaccinations rising increasingly, and the number of cases and the case rate going down so low? Is there still a window in there for problems?
There still is a danger, and I think we need to maintain our vigilance. What we are seeing is that in other states where B117 is expanding, such as in Michigan, they are experiencing surges in cases, which could be associated to the fact that this variant is more transmissible than existing variants. So, for example, in Michigan, about 60% of their cases are this B117 variant, and they are in the midst of a surge in cases and have seen increases in hospitalizations as well. So, you know, I think we're at a pivotal time. We're in a good position. Everything has been good so far, but we need to keep our guard up and maintain kind of masking and social distancing in the near future so that we can ride this out until we can get a larger proportion of the population vaccinated.
And Dr. Martin, we have about a minute left. I've heard of the bad case here being that if we're not vigilant, the longer we let the virus be around and kind of work around society, the more chances we get for some bad variant to just mutate and develop. Is that the argument for really being extra vigilant right now until we get everyone vaccinated?
That's absolutely right. The more opportunity we give the virus to replicate, the more chances are that there emerges a variant which could be potentially more transmissible, lethal, or less vaccines are less effective against. So we need to make sure that we keep transmission down both here in San Diego to prevent that from happening, but also globally, and ensure that we can increase vaccination supplies globally so that we can prevent those variants from emerging in other countries and then arriving here. This week, we just had our first first two cases of the P1 variant first identified in Brazil, which were identified in San Diego County. That variant is associated with a slightly reduced vaccine efficacy. We want to make sure that transmission is low enough that those variants don't arise in other countries or here in the United States and make their way into San Diego.
UC San Diego researcher Dr. Natasha Martin, thank you so much again for walking us through these different scenarios and explaining to us. It's still a pandemic, it's still a problem, but there is some light at the end of that tunnel right now, it feels. Thanks for your time.
Thanks a lot.